flying in to one of the best places to work in the world. We're joining a team of scientists who are sitting at the very top of the Southern Alps, drilling for ice.
Well, what we're doing is a small part of the big scientific effort to understand the climate.
Working in the heart of winter to get vital ice core samples.
Essentially, the best evidence we've got is to go backwards in time to see what affects the climate, how it changes, what are the rhythms and the patterns that it goes through.
Not the easiest thing to do in conditions like this.
You can think of a glacier as having annual layers, which are, each one is a page with writing on it. The writing is telling you about the climate. And the last page that was written is right on the top, and the first page is at the bottom of the glacier.
It's not easy finding an ideal site, and this one's not too bad. We're just below 3,000 metres, it's relatively flat, and there's about 50 metres of ice below us. And the air temperature has to be cold, so when the samples are brought to the surface, they don't begin to melt. They're part of a global effort.
If you have a record just from one place, you can't understand the whole thing. It's like a puzzle. You need many pieces to form the whole picture.
And to the climate change doubters,
it's pretty clear to a lot of scientists that human activity is affecting the climate.
They say what they learn here should interest us all.
We're all going to be affected by climate, we're all affected every day, but is it going to get more changeable, more variable, more extreme events?
They'll have weeks more work, then need to analyse what they get.
That's good glacier ice, that's what we want.
But by the end of the year, there'll be a bigger picture of what the climate has in store. Tom McRae, One News.